I am Leanne Saucy, and I am a 2019 confirmand. Our God, our holy creator, today we gather together to thank you for all you have given us. We thank you for your unconditional love for each and every one of us, and we thank you for guiding us here on this Sunday morning as my fellow confirmands and I confirm our faith in you. Today we ask for your guidance to help us love and care for those who are less fortunate than us. Help us all be the most giving and charitable versions of ourselves that we can be. We are in awe of your goodness and mercy, and your words taught us to be as selfless as we can be, and so we ask you to motivate us to be so. Let us forgive those who have wronged us in the past and be forgiven for all that we have done wrong. We ask you this in the name of your Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
I'm Roger Boss, and I am a 2019 confirmand. Gracious God, come and confirm us in the truth that Christ makes known. We have faith and understanding through your help and gifts alone. Use our hands and guide our feet to do your work in this world. Be with us as we profess our faith in you.
Blake Braun, and I'm a 2019 confirmand. Will you please join me in prayer? On this confirmation Sunday, Lord, create in us a clean heart and renew a right spirit within us. Holy One, as the risen Christ opened the minds of the disciples to understand the scriptures and gave them power through the Holy Spirit to walk boldly in this world, open these confirmands and all this church to the healing, wisdom, and faith given in your word. We pray for all leaders and people that by the power of your cross, you would drive out all violence, domination, and injustice in our world. As you draw us to your Christ, we pray for our war-ravaged world, that you would teach us to walk together in your way of righteousness and peace. We pray for those being confirmed today in your holy church, that our prayers will bear the fruit of action as we hear the cries of pain and suffering of those in need. We pray for the poor, the terrified, and the oppressed, and those who are too much alone, that they may find a home in you as we serve them in your name. Lord, we ask that you receive these confirmands today into your holy church in the light of your steadfast love. Allow them to continue to grow and thrive in the community and body of Christ. Through Christ, with Christ, In the unity of the Holy Spirit, we glorify you, Almighty God, with unending thanks and praise. Amen. Now, in the words taught to us by your Son, Jesus Christ, we lift this prayer to you, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
So how's school going, guys? Good? Yeah? But are you excited for summer? Yeah. Why are you excited for summer? Yeah. Maybe a little bit? Not so you have finals?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah? Is that a lot of studying?
A lot of stress.
A lot of stress?
That's right.
What about you guys? A lot of homework? Yeah. Think you need a break?
Yes.
Yeah? What's the weekend? Are you ready for summer vacation, though? Yeah. You guys ready for summer vacation? Yeah. Are you excited? What about you, Knox?
Oh, I'm so excited.
Well, I just wanted to read you all a little story from Mark chapter 6, verse 30. And it says here, the apostles gathered around Jesus and told him all that they had done and taught. And Jesus said to them, come away to a deserted place all by yourselves and rest a while. For many were coming and going, and they didn't even have time to eat. Are you guys so busy that you aren't even eating? No? What about you, Knox?
Oh, thankfully I am eating.
But that's good. You're taking care of yourself? All right. Well, we are so lucky because we have a Jesus that loves us so much that when we work so hard throughout the year, and our confirmants have been working so hard throughout the year, and now they're getting confirmed today, and you guys are going to have summer vacation. And so Jesus gives us these opportunities to rest and relax, because Knox, do we need rest and relaxation?
We do, absolutely.
Well, how about we say a little prayer? Lord, thank you for the opportunity for us to go on vacations. We know we work so hard and sometimes that we need to go away with our family and friends. So thank you for letting us relax. In your holy name we pray. Amen.
Members and friends in Christ, we gather now to celebrate the gift of grace in the sacrament of baptism. Roger John, do you desire to be baptized into the faith and family of Jesus Christ?
I do.
Will you be led to profess your faith in God?
I will, with the help of God.
Will you renounce the powers of evil and receive the freedom of a new life in Christ?
I will, with the help of God.
Would you join me in the congregational ascent? Jesus Christ calls us to make disciples of all nations and to offer the gift of grace in baptism. Do you, who witness and celebrate this sacrament, promise your love, support, and care for Roger as he lives and grows in Christ?
We promise our love, support, and care.
Roger and Gayatri, do you desire to have your son, Roger John, baptized into the faith and family of Jesus Christ?
Yes.
Will Roger, Gayatri, Bernard, and Nareda encourage Roger John to renounce the powers of evil and receive the freedom of new life in Christ?
We will, with the help of God.
Will you teach him that he may be led to profess Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior?
We will, with the help of God.
Do you promise, according to the grace given to you, to grow with him in the Christian faith, to help him to be a faithful member of the Church of Jesus Christ, by celebrating Christ's presence, by furthering Christ's mission in the world, and by offering the nurture of the Christian church so he may affirm his baptism?
We promise with the help of God.
Witness the water be blessed. By your Spirit, gracious God, this water, by your Holy Spirit, save those who confess in the name of Jesus Christ, that sin may have no power over them. Create new life in Roger, being baptized this day, and glory to you, eternal God, the one who was and is and shall always be. Amen.
In obedience to the head of the church, Roger John Boss II, we baptize you in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen. So in unison, we will welcome Roger. We receive Roger John as a new creation in Christ. We offer our understanding and support as he experiences life. We enfold him in our love, seeking together to grow in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and all people.
Amen. Well, brothers and sisters, would you join me in receiving our newest words of Jesus. I am the vine, you are the branches. Anyone who abides in me, and I in that person, is the one who bears much fruit. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love. Roger, Blake, Antonio, Jennifer, Leanne, and Matthew, do you wish to give your adult affirmation to your participation in the journey of faith in the family of Jesus Christ?
Thank you.
On your journey, is it your intent to be faithful to God by refusing to use evil to manipulate other people? And do you renounce such powers?
Do you understand the love of God shown in Jesus Christ to be a faithful witness of the love of the Creator? And do you know how trust in that love can save you from slavery and can set you free? Do you promise by the grace of God to be Christ's disciple, to resist oppression and evil, to show love and justice, and to witness to the work and word of Jesus Christ as best you are able? If so, answer, I promise with the help of God.
I promise with the help of God.
Do you promise according to the grace given you to grow in the Christian faith and to be a faithful member of Northfield, furthering Christ's mission in the world? If so, answer, I promise with the help of God.
Promise
do you promise to participate in the life and mission of Northfield Church, attending worship and enlisting in the work of this church as it serves this community and the world? If so, answer, I promise with the help of God.
I promise with the help of God.
Let us all unite with the church in all times and places in confessing our faith in the triune God. Will you seek to place your deepest trust in the love of the Creator?
You trust our Creator.
Do you trust that love shown in Jesus Christ?
We trust Jesus Christ.
Are you open to new possibilities through the power of the Holy Spirit?
We trust the Holy Spirit.
We give thanks for every step, in your life's journey that brings you to this decision today. Let the power of God's Spirit rest upon you as you affirm your desire to be confirmed as full members of Northfield Congregational Church. Do you, the members of the 2019 confirmation class, promise to be faithful members of the Northfield Church family, giving of yourself in every way to fulfill your calling as a follower of Christ?
Do you promise to care for and support these new members as they grow in their relationship with God and this church family?
We do.
Let us, the members of Northfield Congregational Church, express our welcome and affirm our mutual ministry in Christ.
We promise you our continuing friendship and prayers as we share the hopes and labors of the Church of Jesus Christ. By the power of the Holy Spirit, may we continue to grow together in God's knowledge and love and be witnesses of Christ's love.
Let us all unite within the tradition of this church by affirming together the covenant of Northfield Congregational Church.
We promise to accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, and we
We promise that so far as possible, we will attend the services of this church, share in its mission, and endeavor to make it a fruitful body of Christians.
I invite the candidates to join me in a prayer of commitment. Let us pray. Creator of all, it is my desire to trust your faithful love above all things,
inspired by the love of Jesus Christ, the power of the Holy Spirit, the call of Scripture, and the care of this community. Help me to be a faithful witness to your love in all I say and do. Amen.
Let us pray together.
Almighty God, grant these your children a love for others, joy in serving you, peace in disagreement, patience in suffering, kindness towards all people, goodness in evil times, faithfulness in temptation, gentleness in the face of opposition, and self-control in all things, thereby strengthening them for their ministry in the world. Help them to live not for themselves, for you.
My brothers and sisters, would you join me in celebrating?
Our first reading is from Acts 10, verses 44 through 48. While Peter was still speaking, the Holy Spirit fell upon all who heard the word. The circumcised believers who had come with Peter were astounded that the gift of the Holy Spirit had been poured out, even on the Gentiles. But they heard them speaking in tongues and extolling God. Then Peter said, "Can anyone withhold the water for baptizing these people who have received the Holy Spirit just as we have?" So he ordered them to be baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Then they invited him to stay for several days.
I'm Jennifer Evans. When I first started coming to confirmation class, I'm going to be honest, I wasn't excited about it. It seemed to me like just another thing that was going to take up time on the weekends. But as the time went on and I learned more and more about the religion that I called myself, I began to appreciate the unity that this belief brings. People that barely know each other come together once a week to pray to someone that they cannot see but believe in with their whole hearts. It brings people together in ways that I did not expect, but that I was attracted to immediately. So about 3 or 4 weeks in, I was totally sold on the way that faith brought people together, but I wasn't exactly sure about the dynamics of my personal relationship with God. That came later, and I can pinpoint the exact time that it happened. It was at our confirmation retreat when we sat down as a group and each individually took turns reading through the whole book of Matthew together by the fire. It was a fairly cold day, and it was so cozy in the room that we were gathered in. We read through the story of Jesus Christ, and as we got to the empty tomb and the revelation of him to the disciples, it started to snow outside. Little flakes that grew heavier, and it was nothing much, but for some reason in that moment, I felt a strong connection to God that I had never felt before. It seemed like a sign that showed that even where 8 confirmands were sitting in a cozy little room reading the Bible, he was watching and making sure we were okay. Despite the fact that so many other injustices were going on in the world, he was present in our lives nonetheless. In that moment, I almost felt like crying because I knew that faith was a strong thing and that now that I was a part of it, I would follow it anywhere. And now, on this day of confirmation, I still will. I'm prepared to follow my faith and the people that come with it throughout my life, and I will carry God with me in whatever path life takes me. Confirmation class changed so much about my outlook on the world, and I am eternally grateful for what it has done for me. There is no way for me to repay the people that guided me on the beginnings of my journey of faith, but I think that if I carry God with me for the rest of it, that will make it fairly even. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. My name is Antonio Milafort, and I'm a 2019 confirmand. The second scripture reading is from the book of John, chapter 5, verses 1 through 6. Everyone who believes that Jesus is the Christ has been born of God, and everyone who loves the parent loves the child. By this we know that we love the children of God, when we love God and obey his commandments. For the love of God is this, that we obey his commandments, and his commandments are not burdensome. For whatever is born of God conquers the world. And this is the victory that conquers the world, our faith. Who is it that conquers the world but the one who believes that Jesus is the Son of God? This is the one who came by water and blood, Jesus Christ. Not with the water only, but with the water and the blood. And the Spirit is the one that testifies, for the Spirit is the truth.
Though I believe in God, I sometimes ask myself whether he is real or not. I truly believe that the chances of a higher being is just a man's way of explaining his reality and his fears. The only thing that are guaranteed in life is death. Yet, I sometimes believe that God has a plan for me, and I am lucky to be a part of this church and this community. I do believe that God will not abandon me, and that I am loved by God, even though God looks after 7.53 billion people. I would advise all youth to consider confirmation to be part of the journey before you make a decision, because how can you come to a decision without the guidance and the information of Pastor Thomas and Reverend Bernard have provided me with a strong foundation to seek and to know God. I hope that I continue this journey and that I help others to find the path that leads to service of the mankind and to help all those individuals who currently need it. But more importantly, a love for the fellow human beings.
Faith. It is a word that possesses so many different meanings, from one's faith in God, to faith in others, and to faith in oneself. And it really varies from person to person. This word is something that I've personally struggled to define myself, but has become much more clear to me through the past year in confirmation class. My faith is an endless trust in God that He will ultimately lead me to what is best as long as I believe in Him, His righteousness and holiness, wisdom and omniscience, almightiness and omnipotence. Even in my darkest times, I can look to Him as He's experienced everything that we have felt, as He was once human too in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. God understands that we are not all perfect and loves us for that reason. Our originality and uniquity are what shapes us into who we are as people. And when God created us, He meant for it to be that way. He wanted us all to be different, but love these differences in ourselves and one another. My time in confirmation class has been a celebration of my faith in God. Coming to Northfield Church every Sunday night to discuss and learn about Him has cemented my faith, opening my eyes to other aspects of God and have deepened my relationship with Him. Where I once really only prayed Sundays at church, I now find myself looking to Him much more often in comfort. Whether it is in smaller moments, like before an exam or a track meet, or bigger moments where I'm coping with fear, loss, or anything else that I feel I really need God's help to get through, I'm comforted knowing that He has listened to my prayers, and that feeling gives me confidence and reassurance. I have learned over confirmation class that God loves each and every one of us for who we are. He appreciates our mistakes and flaws and encourages us to embrace that in ourselves. He has unconditional love to offer to each and every one of us. And we feel that confidence He has in us when we look to Him. He instills us in His love to help us overcome these obstacles in our life that cause us to need help. And that is because God understands. One of the main lessons I learned was that God has also suffered. God has also been jealous. God has been hungry. God has been angry. And God has been sad. And He felt all of these emotions that we feel pain through His Son, Jesus Christ. And I think that makes Him love us even more, that even though we have all felt this pain, we've also all felt overwhelming joy, we've all felt loved, and so much more. And I find it so significant that God has felt all this, as God has been human once too. And again, He understands. And that's the main lesson that I will take away from confirmation class, that God knows what I'm going through. It comforts me knowing that God is always here with us and He will not judge us, even at our worst moments. And instead, He will guide us to the light again and again, as Jesus Himself taught us that even the best of us have flaws and need help. Even though confirmation class is over, I feel that my relationship with God will still grow and take shape as I continue throughout my life. My journey with God is infinite, and my confirmation is to show Him how grateful I am for all of the opportunities He has given me and everything that He continues to do every day for me and my family and everyone around us. Thank you.
This is a scripture reading from the Gospel of John 15, verses 19 through 17, or 9 through 17. As the Father has loved me, so I have loved you. Abide in my love. If you keep my commandments, you will abide in my love, just as I have kept my Father's commandments and abide in His love. I have said these things to you so that my joy may be in you and that your joy may be complete. This is my commandment, that you love one another as I have loved you. No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask Him in my name. I am giving you these commandments so that you may love one another.
As Jesus gave Himself fully for us and then appeared to the disciples bringing peace, so let us now bring wholeness and healing to others through our tithes and gifts.
Amen.
Will you please join me in prayer? Lord God, we offer to you only a portion of what you have given us. All that we have is from your creative hand. All that we can give away, we do through Jesus' love. All our renewal comes from the Holy Spirit's wisdom. Deal graciously with these gifts so that others may have joy. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. join me in prayer. Father, we give you thanks for the gift of your body and blood. And as we prepare to partake of this meal that you set forth for us, make us ready. We ask this in your holy name. Amen.
Amen.
For I received from the Lord what I delivered to you on this day, that on the night in which he was betrayed, Jesus took the bread and broke it. He said, "This is my body broken for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same manner, he took the cup after supper, saying, "This cup is the new covenant sealed with my blood. As often as you eat of this bread and drink from this cup, you do proclaim my resurrection till I return."
Would you join me in prayer? Lord, we give thanks today for the blessing of our sustenance and for the life and love this confirmation class has and will give to the community. We lift our hearts to bring up these joyful young adults and remember you with the bread and wine of our collective faith. Guide their hands to join ours in the work we've set out to do, and make this lovely community brighter with them as confirmed members of the church. Let us rejoice in the christening of this confirmation class as men and women of God. Amen.